There are many different degrees of visual impairment, from partially sighted to completely blind. Visual impairment and blindness have many different causes. While some types of visual impairment can be treated, complete blindness has so far been incurable. Will science ever be able to fully restore vision to the blind? In recent years, researchers have attempted to restore vision by creating an artificial eye, or retina. Diseases such as age-related macular degeneration damage light-sensitive cells in a patient's retina. Scientists have addressed this with some degree of success by replacing those damaged retinal cells with tiny, light-sensitive chips, or by providing direct electrical stimulation from an electrode array surgically attached to the surface of the retina. A small video camera on a pair of glasses sends wireless signals to a processor, which relays them to electrodes that stimulate retinal ganglion cells. These methods provide only limited vision, but it's a welcome improvement. Users can detect light sources and high contrast objects, such as doors or windows, and some can read larger letters. Still, resolution is an issue, as the few electrodes on a chip can't match the millions of photoreceptor cells in a healthy eye. This should improve over time with further iterations of these chips. These methods, miracles of modern science, have helped hundreds of people. However, most blind people have damage to the nerve system connecting the retina to the visual cortex at the back of the brain, which processes vision. A bionic eye or retinal chips alone won't help them. A new implant that transmits video images directly to the visual cortex, bypassing the optic nerve, shows exciting promise to help solve this problem. The nervous system and human-created electronic devices process electrical information in a similar fashion. The pacemaker and the cochlear implant demonstrate this. Currently, direct cortical transmission requires brain surgery to place a cable-powered neuroimplant, known as a Utah array, directly into the brain. The implant has 100 tiny electrode spikes, each a millimeter long, which pierce the surface of the brain when inserted. This allows the electrodes to sit much closer to the neurons, using much lower electrical current. High electrical current can cause seizures. Presently, the implant must be removed after about 6 months, a major drawback. Researchers hope to refine the technique and extend the period of use to several decades. Current resolution is a rudimentary 10 by 10 pixels. Not much, but better than total blindness. 25 by 25 pixels would produce reasonable vision. By adding more electrodes, resolution could reach 60 by 60 pixels or more. Still, after years of blindness, trial patients are elated to be able to see simple shapes and basic outlines, even at this early low resolution. One patient was able to identify basic shapes, ceiling fans, and even people. The technology is still far from perfect, but now we see light at the end of the tunnel. While this technology is still being developed, you can help right now by giving visual assistance to blind and low vision people on your phone. Be My Eyes connects blind or low vision people with sighted volunteers for visual assistance through a live video call. Follow the links below the video to see how you can help. Like, follow, subscribe, and catch us next time to see how you, plus science, can help save the world.